Google Analytics 4 is absolutely crucial to have installed within your Shopify store. So in this video, I want to walk you through that, and stick around to the end. So I'll actually show you exactly what you need to be looking at to make sure that the connection is set up properly. Testing the connection, right? To ensure that everything is working good. Starting off with number one, I'm going to make this video where I'm going to try to hit both. You are a brand new person who has just a brand new Shopify store, has never used Google Analytics 4. And I'm actually gonna walk you through, if you have Google Analytics in the past and you have to maybe fix a couple of things just to make sure that everything is working properly like it should. Now, if you're brand new, you don't have to necessarily follow these steps, but if you have had Google Analytics in your store before, the first thing to do is to sort of remove any old code or any old connections that you may have with Google Analytics. So the first place that I would go to check for that would be your online store under themes. You'll want to go to your current theme and hit those three little dots and then click on edit code. And then in here, you go to your theme.liquid and then you'll have to find if you have added any Google Analytics code in here. What I like to do is click here on the actual code, then hit Command or Control F to search for something. And then you can type in Google. Now, if nothing shows up, more than likely you don't have any Google code installed in here. Something else that I like to do is just scroll down till you see the end of the head code right here. So a lot of times you have to insert some code in here. So you'll see like there's nothing necessarily Google related right over here. And then your body tag as well, usually towards the end of your body tag, you may have some additional scripts or something like that that have been added to this. Again, all you want to do is remove anything regarding Google Analytics that's part of your code right here. And the reason why I search for Google is because within the code, it will say Google tag or even Google Analytics right within there. So if you search for Google and you don't find it, or if you go to those two spots and you don't see anything regarding Google, then more than likely you don't have any code installed right over there. Now, another spot where you might have a connection is under preferences. Now if we scroll down over here, you'll see that we had a previous Google Analytics account in here installed. We can click change and then just delete that and then save. That way we're getting rid of any old Google Analytics code that's within our store. So essentially this spot right here, they'll get rid of it eventually. But for right now, what my recommendation would be is to install the sales channel, which is Google, the Google channel. It used to be called Google channel. I think now it's Google and YouTube. So let's go ahead and add that to our Shopify store. If we go to sales channels, as you can see, we don't have it necessarily installed in here, but you can type in Google right here, and then this will take you directly to the app store. And then right within here, you'll see Google and YouTube. And then once you click on it, you just want to make sure that it's actually the developer is actually made by Google. Once you've verified that's the one, click add app, and then you want to go ahead and install it. Now, for the rest of what we need to do, we could technically go about it from right here. So you'll want to connect your Google account. In here, it will make you select your actual Google account. Now, if you don't have a Google account, then I would just create a simple Gmail for your store. So for example, we have Little Bits Treats. Maybe I'll create a Little Bits at gmail.com. And I'll use that as the Google account that I will post on Google Analytics. For this example, I have a store for whatever reason. Okay, there. So this is just an example account that I've had. So I'm going to go ahead and allow all that. Now, because this is the Google and YouTube sort of sales channel, it has a lot of different features mixed in within it. Things like Google Shopping or selling your products on YouTube, etc., which we have a video for that. You can check that out. But all we want to do for the purpose of this video is just set up Google Analytics 4. It's actually very simple. So right within here, as long as you have all this connected, you don't have to keep scrolling and connecting your merchant account or any of these things. Again, for right now. Eventually, yeah, you want to have all those features within your store. Obviously, if you want to sell on Google and YouTube, etc. But for right now, all we need to do is look at for this blue box that will tell you to looking for only to set up Google Analytics 4. Yes, that's us. So all we have to do is click on get started and you'll see the information down below will start to change. Now, because this is a brand new account, we don't have any properties. So this would be if someone was starting brand new. Again, all I have is a Google account and that's it. I haven't even set up a Google Analytics account per se. Because of that, it will say in here that there's no properties found for this actual Gmail account. So we're gonna have to go over here and click on this, and this will take us to Google Analytics. Now, this will take us to the sort of help desk, right, for analytics. So this will kind of walk you through the process. But really what you wanna click on is analytics up here, sign into analytics, click our account, and then we can click on start measuring. So from here, we'll fill out some of this information so we can get the account set. Okay, so this is for my company, Little Bits Treats, account data and sharing, all that. So that was my account name. Now I have to create the property. Think of a property as any individual website or app that you may have that you want to track individual analytics for. So for this property name, we're gonna do Little Bit Treats Shopify website. And then it will have you select your time zone and your currency. Those are correct. And then it will ask you to describe your business. So the category regarding pets. Pets and animals. Okay. And then it will ask you, for your general business objectives. In here, it really doesn't matter too much on what you select. But really, we want to drive online sales, raise brand awareness, examine user behavior. Click create. You'll agree to the terms of service. And then what we have here is a website. So we're going to do web. All right. So you have to fill out your website URL, the stream name. I'm just going to put my website in here. And then enhanced measurement. You definitely want to make sure that that's already pre-selected. If it's not, then just go ahead and click on it and then create stream. So now that we've created that property, I'm going to go back over here. Google Analytics will actually try to walk you through how to install it manually, etc. But what we're going to do is we're going to go head back over here to Shopify, the same page that we're at. We're going to refresh that page. And then right within here, we should see the property that we just created. So as you can see, because it's the only one that I have, it's the only one that's going to show up in here. I'm going to hit connect. And that's it. You've successfully set up Google Analytics 4 on your store. If you already have something already created for you, you can actually go through the same steps, right? So if in this dropdown, you don't find the Google Analytics 4 account, then you can go in here and create the account. Now, let me show you how it will look if this is an old account that we have. So if I'm logged into this other account, I can go to admin, and then right here within properties, I can create a new property and then follow the exact same steps that I just went through to actually create that new property. That new property would essentially be that GA4 property. So inside of here, inside of your company name, you'll see probably your old Google Analytics account, and then you'll see the new one that you've created. I just labeled it GA4 so I don't get them confused. Obviously, you probably want to keep the old one just for records and for data purposes, but this new one will be the GA4. So because I have these two properties in this other account, if I were to connect this account to my Shopify, then I will have the option to select between these two. And again, you just want to make sure that you select the one that the newly created one, which is the GA4, which as you can see, I think that one of the main differences is going to be the new GA4 ones are not going to have the UA towards the front. So it's more of a simple property number ID to them. Now, something that Google Analytics will tell you here is that it may take up to 48 hours for the connection to be fully there and to actually be start collecting data. So if you connect this right away and you don't see data coming in, then that might be the reason for that. All right, now for the fun part, we're going to test this connection. For the purpose of this video, I actually haven't spent too much time since the connection of the GA4 to my Shopify store. So I just wanna let you know, like the 48 hours may not be full 48 hours. It may be just a few hours really. But I've opened the website on a brand new browser and tab. So we're using Chrome over here now. And I've gone through some of the pages, I've added to cart, etc. Now, if I go back over here to my home, to my reports, you'll see that users in the last 30 minutes, number one, that's me, shout out. We can actually click on view real time and we can actually see the pages that I've navigated towards, the products that I've seen, etc. And all this additional information. Now, that means that this is actually working properly. Obviously, this is the area that we're in, so for sure this is working properly. Something else that you could do in order to even debug it a little bit further is going back over here to Chrome. If you go to the Chrome Web Store, you can actually search for Google Analytics, and there's this Google Analytics Debugger. You can add this to Chrome. Those are gonna be an extension. We go back over here to our store. Let me pin this. And then we just wanna make sure that we click on it. And then we can actually go through this whole process. I'm gonna go ahead and actually add this to cart. Let's see if we go to the checkout page. And if we go back over here, you go to your admin, make sure that your property is selected. Scroll all the way down here, click on debug view. If you give it a few seconds, you should be able to see all the things that are firing as far as the pixel and Google Analytics wise. You just see all the events happening right within here. If you don't, then there's gonna be things that you'll need to fix or redo the connection again. This is a surefire way to make sure that all the right things are actually firing here correctly. My suggestion as well would be to actually go through the whole checkout process, like actually go from your homepage all the way to the thank you page essentially. And then you can just refund that transaction. But that again will allow you to see all the events that are happening. Make sure that all the purchasing events, all the add to cart events, everything is actually tracking properly. The actual setup is really easy to do, as you can see. And this debug view will allow you to essentially just see it real time, right? As you're navigating through your website, as those things are happening right within here. Now, you've probably installed Google Analytics because you want to increase your conversions. You want to make your site faster. You want to see the back end of what's going on. This is sort of the tip of the iceberg. This is for you to be well aware of what's going on. In order to make some changes, I highly, highly recommend that you check out this next video. We'll go over some changes that you want to make through your checkout process to increase those conversions on your Shopify store. See you then. I don't know where it's going to be. Right here, right here.